I welcome you all in the next video tutorial of the chromatography series. And in this video tutorial, we are going to see the important chromatographic technique, that is HPTLC. And we have covered the TLC studies, that is a thin layer chromatographic studies. So HPTLC stands for high performance thin layer chromatography. So how we will increase the performance of TLC? That is HPTLC. HPTLC is nothing but in simple terms, we can say that it is an advanced form of TLC. Because please recall the previous knowledge of TLC. We prepare TLC plates in the laboratory with the help of silica gel G. Or sometimes TLC plates are also available in the market, commercially available in the market, that is known as the pre-coated TLC plates. In the TLC plates preparation, in the TLC method, we will again prepare the mobile phase. Yes, we will again prepare the mobile phase in the HPTLC. In TLC, yes, we will take the spot, we can say we'll apply the spot with the help of capillary. Okay, and then we'll put our plate in the developing chamber and that solvent system will rise through the capillary action. But in the HPTLC, this process becomes the automated. HPTLC is a sophisticated instrument which have an automatic sampler. Okay, that will automatically put the spots on your TLC plate and it will run. And in case of TLC, we are again, after the running of the plate, we will put our plate out and we will detect by using various detection methods. Yes, in case of HPTLC, we also use different detection method, but in an advanced form, in an automatic form. So HPTLC, in simple meaning, we can say that it is an advanced form of TLC. So let's start the chromatography technique, that is the HPTLC. So HPTLC, that is the high performance thin layer chromatography, is an automated, okay, sophisticated form and improved version or improved method of TLC. Just see what happened when I type in the Google images, the HPTLC. Just see this. Yes, a computer system appears. Means it is an automatic form. It is a sophisticated instrument. That is the HPTLC. So it is an advanced form of TLC. You can see this is the automatic sampler. Don't worry, we will do it in detail. So this is now next. Yes, it is a very important. Generally, TLC, you can say TLC is used for which purpose? Yes, qualitative analysis. But HPTLC is used for qualitative as well as, tell me, as well as quantitative. So with the help of HPTLC, we can do both qualitative and quantitative analysis of a particular sample of a particular, you can say the mixture of the phytoconstituent or any other compound or a mixture. So as I have said that we discussed that HPTLC is an advanced form of TLC. So tell me, what is the basic principle involved in HPTLC? Yes, you all are right, adsorption. So HPTLC based upon the principle of adsorption. So please again tell me that how separation take place. Please recall the knowledge. Yes, the compounds which have higher affinity towards the stationary phase, okay, so they will travel slow, and the compounds which have higher affinity towards the mobile phase, yes, they will travel faster. Okay, so the compound present in the mixture, they get separated because of affinity of the compound either towards stationary phase or towards mobile phase. So this is the basic principle of adsorption. So let's see the difference between TLC and HPTLC. It is very simple. Yes, TLC is a handmade, it is a manual operated procedure, whereas HPTLC in which we use pre-coated plates. No doubt we are also using pre-coated plates in the TLC, but we can also made TLC plate with the help of hand. But in HPTLC, only pre-coated plates are used. And what is the difference between hand-made plates and the pre-coated plates. Yes, the main difference is the layer of the adsorbent or the thickness of the adsorbent. Because ultimately, TLC or HPTLC stands for what? Thin layer. How much thin? Kitni thin layer? So this is the answer. In TLC, again, 250 micrometer up to, but in HPTLC, again, a very, very thin layer, 100 to 200 micrometers. Okay? So, next is the, there is a procedure we will do in the HPTLC. There is a pre-washing of the plate. It is not allowed in the TLC, but it is must in the HPTLC. Because we have to pre-washing the HPTLC plate. We will see that. First, see this. Application of the sample, it is manual, and here it is, automatic sampler is used. So, the shape of the sport is like a band form. In the HPTLC, we also use the band form. Okay, sample volume is quite high, 1 to 10 in TLC, whereas in HPTLC it is 0.2 to 5 microliters. Okay, because it is an automatic system. Efficiency is low of TLC, whereas in HPTLC it is quite high. Analysis time in case of TLC is slow, very slow. But in HPTLC it is a fast instrument because it is an advanced form. So yes, it will give better results and faster results also. So development chamber in TLC we require more amount of solvent, whereas in HPTLC yes, we require very less amount of solvent. So sport size in TLC is 2 to 4 mm, okay, quite high, but quite big. And HPTLC it is only 0.5 to 1 mm, okay, that is the sport size. So scanning in HPTLC, we can scan with the help of UV. We can also basically detect our sports in TLC by various methods like destructive or non-destructive. Okay, so the non-destructive methods include iodine chamber visualization and UV reduction, whereas the destructive method involves spraying reagents with the help of different spraying bottles. Okay, and we have different type of spraying reagents for different compounds. Okay, let's see in HPTLC we use scanning methods like UV, or can say visible. We can also use different type of spectrophotometers or densitometer, because HPTLC is not only for the qualitative analysis, but it also gives us the quantitative estimation also. So yes, it has very much advantageous than the TLC. So just see this photograph. So this is the HPTLC chromatogram of different band forms are applied. So this is the very, very clear views of different compounds. So yes, it is an advanced form. It is a very sophisticated instrument. That is the HPTLC. So we will do the next part, that is the full procedure, in the next video. So do not share this video. I have acknowledged all the resources that I have used to prepare this video, especially SlideShare, Google Images, OER, that is Open Education Resources, etc. And also, these are the references that I have used to prepare this video. So see you in the part 2 video of HPTLC. I welcome you all in the part 2 video of the HPTLC. In this video, we are going to cover the different steps involved in the HPTLC, that is high performance thin layer chromatography. Always remember one thing, it is the advanced form of the TLC that we have already completed in the previous videos. So before going to watch this video, I request you to watch the video of TLC thoroughly, then watch this HPTLC. Okay, so let's see the different steps involved in the HPTLC. So look at this. Selection of the chromatographic plates. First of all, we will select the chromatographic plates. Then there is a procedure of, that is the plate layer pre-washing. We will see this in detail. Then the activation of the pre-coated plates. I hope you remember that in the normal TLC, we again have to activate our TLC plates in the hot air oven at a particular temperature and the time condition. And generally, in case of TLC, if we are preparing the handmade, or can say with the help of silica gel G slurry TLC plates, we have to activate the plate for at least 120 degrees Celsius for 30 minutes. So in case of HPTLC, we will also again go for the activation of the pre-coated plates. So yes, sample preparation and application is the fourth step. Fifth is the selection of the mobile phase, again very critical. So it will depend upon the sample that we have isolated, that we have to screen, we have to monitor. So it is very crucial. Then preconditioning, again this is important. This is again a very, very simple concept. These are very, very simple. Preconditioning is there. Then we have to develop the chromatographic development and drying. Then detection, visualization, of course we have to detect and visualize by different methods. in this case also we use iodine chamber, or you can also go for the UV. Okay, UV light will adopt for detection visualization purpose. And of course the documentation, because this is a sophisticated instrument, so we will finally found a peak or graph and we will document in a particular form. So let's see the first step, that is the pre-coated plates. So first of all, we will select the chromatographic plates, and there are different type of pre-coated plates that are commercially available in the market. And the support material for the plates, generally we are using the aluminium based TLC in the HPTLC type. And the sorbent, or you can say the adsorbent layer in the HPTLC is of silica gel, but you can see this 60F. So F stands for fluorescent. So we can use the fluorescent TLC plate that will give fluorescent upon exposure to UV light. Okay, so we are prepared, we are using the silica gel G, and we will add in silica gel a fluorescent compound so that the plate become fluorescent and we will able to see the more detection, the more visualization, or the better results, or the better clarity, you can say. Okay, other sorbents use like aluminium oxide, cellulose, etc. Next important step is the pre-washing. This is nothing, this is a very very simple step. It is all purification step of the TLC plate. Generally, sometimes the TLC plates we procure from the market are might contain some impurities. So for that, we will run the plate in a solvent. Like we will take the TLC plate as such and we will dip it in a particular solvent. So suppose this is a full TLC plate. What you will do, you will not apply any spoon. You will take this TLC plate and directly add in the developing chamber. Okay, you will directly add this plate in your developing chamber and you will use a particular mobile phase. Like generally we use the methanol. Okay, so this is the basically done for the purification. So all the impurities which are present in the plate, might suppose these are the impurity present in the plates. So when you run this plate in a particular solvent or a particular mobile phase, what will happen? As the solvent will rise, it will again take all the impurities with itself, and the player, we can say the plate will get purified. So this is used for the purification of the TLC plate. Again, a very simple step, that is the activation of the pre-coated plate. Yes, we have to take our HPTLC plate, that is a pre-coated plate, and put in the oven for at least 110 to 120 degrees Celsius for 30 minutes. So this step will remove what? Yes, the moisture, the humidity that might acquire by your pre-coated TLC plates. Okay, so this is very simple step, the activation of the pre-coated plates. You will put your plate in the hot air oven at a particular temperature for a particular time. So after the activation, the next step is the sample preparation and application. So in case of HPTLC, we will prepare the sample by using different type of, you can say, solvents. Like we use the HPTLC grade or high graded methanol, or ethanol, or any other organic solvent, and this always depend upon the sample that we have to analyze. Okay, suppose we have to analyze a fat soluble, or you can say a non-polar sample. So we cannot use directly methanol because it might be insoluble in the methanol. So we will use some non-polar solvent to dissolve the particular sample. Just see this, methanol is used, chloroform methanol, different ratio, ethyl acetate methanol. These are the different type of ratio of the organic solvent that we use to prepare the sample. And the sample application is done by using different micro syringes, capillary tubes, etc. So these are the micro syringes. Next is the selection of the mobile phase. So as I have discussed earlier, the selection of the mobile phase is the most critical step. And it will depend again upon the sample that we have to analyze. Suppose if we are using the very non-polar sample, then we must use a non-polar mobile phase. Okay, so in this way, this is the most crucial step. And we use different type of organic solvents, whether, for example, chloroform is to methanol is to water in combination. Okay, ethyl acetate is to chloroform in combination. It will depend upon the sample that we have to analyze. The next step is the preconditioning, or you can say the chamber saturation. How it is achieved? Suppose this is your chamber. What you will do, this is the chamber. You will add a, so first of all, you will add a mobile phase in your chamber. Okay. And then you will cover with a lid. This is the covered lid of the chamber. Then what you will do? You will put a small strip of the filter paper inside your chamber. Okay. Just before approximately 30 to 40 minutes of the dipping of your TLC plate, what you will do? You will add a strip of the filter paper in your chamber. Okay. In your developing chamber. Why? For saturation. Means what this filter strip will do, this will carry your mobile phase in this way, and as this mobile phase generally contain volatile organic compounds or organic solvents. So what will happen? A complete saturation, or you can say this whole chamber contain appropriate amount of vapor of your mobile phase, and this is known as the complete chamber saturation, or you can say the preconditioning. So this is very simple. You can saturate chamber by lining the filter paper for 30 minutes prior to the development. Okay. So sometimes unsaturated chamber cause high RF values. So this is very important step. Now the seventh step is the chromatography development and drying. So in this, the plates are spotted with a particular amount of sample, and first they are air dried and then they added in the developing chamber. And the development can be achieved by ascending development, descending, or you can also go for the horizontal type. Next is detection and visualization. Yes, we will use long UV and short UV in the UV cabinets. And we know the long UV is 366 nanometer. Remember this value. And the short UV is 254 nanometer wavelength. So we will check our detection or the TLC plate in the UV cabinet. But if our sample does not contain any UV active compound, then we do not use this method. This method is applicable only for the sample that it contains the conjugation, or you can say the UV active compounds. And for non-UV active compounds, we will use different methods. Like we will might dip in the 1% iodine solution. Yes, the last step is the scanning. And for scanning, we use different type of detectors might also be used in the HPTLC. Like lamp selector, grading mirror. This is the basically construction of a detector. And what we will measure? We will measure the peak height and the area under spot as measured by an instrument that is recorded. And finally, we'll go for the documentation work. So here it is, the peaks were appeared in the HPTLC, and we will document our whole procedure or the results. So I hope this will give you a brief idea about the HPTLC. So we will do the third part of HPTLC, in which we also again see the main part of the HPTLC again. We'll revise that. So these are the references I have used, and do not share this video in any platform. Thank you for patient and listening. I welcome you all in the part 4 video of the HPTLC. So far we have covered the detailed procedure or the instrumentation principle of HPTLC. And in this video tutorial, we are going to see some of the important applications of HPTLC. Because in our syllabus, we have to focus upon the application part. Okay, so HPTLC is widely used, as you can see, in the pharmaceutical industry for the quality control purpose, identity, quality, purity, etc. And yes, the chromatographic study, or you can say the HPTLC, gives us an idea of the compound identity. Okay, identity, then quality, then purity of a particular mixture. And it is widely used in the Ayurvedic industry also. Number of the Ayurvedic compounds, number of the phytoconstituent have been quantified with the HPTLC analysis. In the previous video, we have covered the example of the ribidioside that is present in the Stevia ribodiana plant. So vitamin C, you can say ascorbic acid in amla, andrographolite in andrographis plant, you can say eugenol in clove, or any other compound, they have been quantified by HPTLC. So HPTLC is widely used in the pharmaceutical industry as well as in the Ayurvedic industry. Next, the food analysis, just for the quality control purpose, for the determination of pesticide, stability testing, etc. It is widely used. Yes, it has a clinical application like drug screening and industrial application for the development and the optimization of a particular substance. It is used in the forensic analysis for the determination of some unwanted, or you can say the poisonous investigations. In environmental analysis, in biomedical studies, in cosmetic, in natural product chemistry, look at this, glycosides in herbal drugs, piperine in piper longum. So there are different types of metabolites have been quantified and estimated with the help of HPTLC. Okay, so it is useful as a fingerprinting technique. It emerged as a identification, as a fingerprinting technique for the different plants. And nowadays we are preparing the fingerprint of a particular plant, because as we know, we humans have a different fingerprint. My fingerprint is different, and your students, you are listening to me, you have different fingerprint. In the same way, plant also has a fingerprint. That is the chemical fingerprint that we are preparing. The humans are preparing the fingerprint of the plants that will help us to identify the different plants from each other. So HPTLC is one of the technique that is involved in the plant fingerprinting. Okay, and DNA fingerprinting of plant is quite common. Okay, so next is the analysis of drugs in blood. To HPTLC is also helpful in different type of analysis of drugs that are someone if I have taken that is present in the blood sample. So I hope this is clear to you. So these are the references. This is the reference of the particular presentation that I've used, and I personally found it very useful. So thank you for patience and listening. I do not share this video in any other platform. It is strictly prohibited. So thank you for patience listening.